Hello, everybody, and welcome back to TeamSupport University. As many of you know, I'm Grayson.
And I'm Evan, and we do want to extend a warm welcome to our TeamSupport family, and thank you for joining our TeamSupport University webinar, where our focus today is going to be on our new and improved search tool.
Also, happy holidays from everyone here at TeamSupport. I am currently in search for Christmas presents for everyone on my list. It's a lot to do. How's your Christmas shopping going, Evan? Anything you have your eye on?
I've got my eye on a PlayStation 5, but so far no luck on my side here. So how about yourself?
You know, I would not mind a vacation to somewhere that is over 30 degrees right now.
Yeah, I think we'd all agree with you there. And yet here I am. I agreed to meet up with two friends in the mountains in January. So the wrong temperature there.
Yeah, that's for sure. Good luck with that. All right, let's get moving.
All right. So as many of you know, we have a new monthly webinar series, Primetime with Pete Khanna. That is where our CEO will host an interaction with everyone tomorrow at 1 p.m. Central Time.
Yeah, and Pete will be updating everyone about TeamSupport and our products. He'll be answering any questions as well as offering insight into the B2B support industry.
If you open the chat box in the GoToWebinar panel, the description of the chat box will have the link to register for next month's Primetime with Pete. But Pete, please feel free to ask any questions if you have any about that particular webinar.
Perfect. And one last thing we wanted to mention was that our new reporting and analytics solution called Team Insights, it launched on December 1st. We call it the next evolution of reporting, and you can learn all about it at teaminsights.com, or you can send an email to sales@teaminsights.com. Now, let's go ahead and get back to TeamSupport University.
All right, everyone. So if this is your first time joining us, welcome. Our TeamSupport University webinars are great for anyone who is looking for a deep dive into specific features. We share our knowledge, best practice, tips, and tricks that we've discovered through our time here within the application.
Yes, and these webinars can last up to 50 minutes with a Q&A near the end. We don't expect for it to go that long for this webinar. Now, if we do move through this topic too quickly, just keep in mind that we will be sharing a recording of this presentation early next week.
And to ensure that you all have access to all of our helpful resources for TeamSupport, we wanted to provide you a few links, starting with our support hub, which can be found at support.teamsupport.com.
Yep, and within the support hub, TeamSupport offers features like our knowledge base, which can be searched to find documentation, helpful hints, and tips and tricks.
You'll also notice that we have a new option that took the place of our help documentation. You can now easily navigate to our release notes for any updates to TeamSupport.
Yeah, but as always, if you have any questions, concerns, or comments, our support team is readily available via our chat option.
And all of those links can be found in your TeamSupport instance in the top right-hand corner under the help button.
That's right. Now, one area we always like to point out as well is our community. Now, you may have visited our community to chat about a feature request or to look at great customer hub examples, but we now have a TeamSupport University specific topic within the community.
Yes, and by bringing the TSU to the community, that provides us a place for you to ask questions for each topic, and if you don't get a chance to during the webinar. Grayson and I will be answering those directly that we received today, as well as giving helpful best practices.
Yeah, and you'll always be able to see what our next TSU topic is, along with links to resources that will be covered in the webinar. Once this TSU is completed, we will post all of your questions, as well as other exciting content for each TSU webinar.
All right, so now let's go with a quick rundown of what we're going to be covering today. We are going to start with a look at our top search and our advanced search tool. So we are going to take a look at a comparison between the two.
Yep, and next I'll be covering the different ways to search in TeamSupport.
And after that, Grayson and I will show you some advanced search options as well as some best practices to help you get started.
Perfect. And lastly, we will get to the Q&A and trivia towards the end of this webinar. Now that we got the housekeeping out of the way, let's get to our favorite part of this webinar, the TSU gift card giveaway.
Yes, and who doesn't need a quick gift card to help you get through the Christmas season here?
I know I do. I'm a little frightened to brave the shopping mall crowds this time of year.
Yeah, you and me both. So at the end of the webinar, we will be posting a trivia question on our community. If you are worried about getting lost, it is super easy to get over there. In TeamSupport, simply click the help button in the top right-hand corner and select Support Hub.
Yeah, you'll see the community tile, which takes you to a list of topics. You would just select TeamSupport University and choose the topic for today.
You should see the question as part of the community topic. All you have to do is click reply located in the bottom right of the question post when it appears.
Yep. And the first person to give us the correct answer will win today's prize. So without further ado, Evan, you ready to get us started?
Yep, let's go ahead and start the show. So let me switch out of our PowerPoint here and let's switch on over to TeamSupport. All right, so let's start by going to our dashboard here. All right, so as many of you, when you log into TeamSupport, a lot of you will navigate to your dashboard. So the first area that we are going to take a look at is going to be our quick search tool up here at the top of the page here. One thing to note is that this search bar is going to be available on any page as you navigate through TeamSupport. So you can easily search and jump to a ticket quickly from a page that you are on as you're working in TeamSupport. Now for our use case today, we have had some reports that our Donkey Kong machines are malfunctioning, specifically around the third level or the jungle level. So we want to try to gather up all the tickets that we can so that we can communicate to our customers the fix for that issue. So starting with the top search bar up here, as you can see in there, it says search for a ticket name or ticket number. Those are the only two things that you should search for using the top search bar. So as you and type in the number here, so once we start typing in 130, we're going to get a list of tickets. Now, once we type in another character here, then it is going to give us the one relevant result. So if you're searching by ticket number, you're only going to get one ticket number if you type in the full ticket number. But again, you may get some multiple results if you only have a partial search or you are searching by the ticket name. You can also sort by relevance or you can sort by date created there. All right, so that covers our top search topic there. As mentioned, again, only search for ticket name or ticket number. If you need to search for anything more than that, you are going to do that on our search page over here on the left-hand side. So let's go ahead and switch over there, and now we'll talk more about our advanced search tool. All right, so the search bar here is going to be very familiar for anyone that has used a search engine before. So let's start out just by typing in the keywords Donkey Kong. And if I can type those in correctly, then I will get some results.
It's always when you're presenting that you're
exactly.
Typing always.
Yeah, you get fat fingers when you start presenting here. All right, so by typing in our keywords Donkey Kong here, we can see that 11 results are found. The search tool can pull in information from various areas of the platform to return those results, and it is going to show your terms highlighted in bold there, the bold font. So you can see where it's picking up the keywords Donkey Kong, and it's bolding exactly where it's pulling from. But as you can see, it is pulling from the actions of the ticket. It can pull from the product name, the ticket name. So again, it's going to be able to pull in various areas to pull in your results here. All right. So one thing to note is that the available search fields that it can search by, there are a whole number of them that we're not going to be able to cover all of them in our webinar today. But in the TSU community post, there is a link to the KB article concerning the advanced search page. So you can see exactly all of the parameters that can be searched for using the advanced search tool here. All right, so once we have pulled up our results, we can sort by a few different options. The default is going to be by relevant, so it'll pull in the most relevant topics here. But if we click on the arrow here, we can get some different options here. so we can see relevance, date created, due date, or last modified. Now we know this is a pretty recent issue, so I'm going to sort by date created so I can see the newest tickets up there at the top. So it's going to reorder my list of tickets. Now, if I scroll down through my results, I can see some older tickets here. So I can see this one was raised in October, this one in September. So I want to actually add some filters to refine my results over here on the right-hand side. So when I click on add a filter, it's going to pull up a drop-down list with all of the available in the search tool here. Where again, we're not going to cover all of them. We don't have that much time to go through each and every one of them today, but we do want to show you a few different ones just for practical purposes. So let's start with severity. We know that this issue is a high severity issue. So we are going to start by clicking on our severity drop-down list here and clicking on high. So that's going to filter our results just a little bit. Now we also know that this particular issue is specific to our software, not necessarily the Donkey Kong machine hardware. So what we're going to do is in the white area next to severity, we can actually add another filter. So we can add multiple filters onto the same search results. So let's go ahead and add a product filter here. And then unlike the severity, which had a drop-down list, we are actually going to need to search through our products, and Grayson will elaborate a little bit more about that here shortly, but we're going to type in Donkey Kong here, and we know it's a software issue, so we'll choose software. So now we are filtering to only the tickets that have the product Donkey Kong software and are set to the high severity. So now we found all five tickets that are related to our issue, so that we can then communicate to our customers here. Now, to demonstrate other ways that you can filter those options, we're going to go ahead and reset the parameters. So let's go ahead and click on reset all. Now, when we do that, you will see that it will still keep our remaining filters in here. It just reset the parameters that we had set on the filter level. So to get rid of those, we'll actually click on the individual X's here and remove those filters one by one. Now let's go ahead and try another filter. Let's go ahead and add a date filter. So if you are going to do a date, you can actually select a date or a range. So we know that this issue was first reported on the 10th. So we're going to gather up tickets that were raised between the 10th and the 14th. And voila, again, now we have all of the tickets that we're looking for. We would still need to refine our results because we can pretty easily see on ticket 1305 that this level glitch is actually for the fourth level, not the third level. So that's not part of the returns that we're looking for. We can also filter by open and close tickets. So if we're only looking for open tickets here, we can actually choose the different radio buttons. So if I click on the default is going to be show all tickets. But if we go ahead and click on show only open tickets, it's going to refine our results. Now we could filter to our closed tickets because there may be the answer that we're looking for in our closed tickets. So that's an easy way to see between your open and closed items whenever you're searching. And the last one that we're going to take a look at is ticket tags. There are a number of benefits for ticket tags in the system, specifically for suggested solutions or ticket deflection, of which we do have another TSU webinar covering that specifically, but it can also help you with your search results. So we went ahead and tagged all of our tickets that are concerning this level with the keyword jungle. So we can search through the list or we can type it in, click on jungle, and it's only going to return, again, the five tickets that we're looking for. So those are just a couple different ways that you can search and filter through your results. Now, again, let's go ahead and take out all of our filters for today. And the last thing I want to elaborate on this page here is currently we have been searching through our tickets. We can change what we want to search for by clicking on the drop listed here. Now, a few of the areas which Grayson is about to cover, such as customers, our knowledge base, and our product section, have the search technology built on that page specifically. Now, there are a couple pages that you would have to search for. This page here specifically, those areas being the water cooler and the wiki here. So those three pages do not have the search bar up at the top. So if you did need to search through those three areas, you will have to come to the advanced search page. But with that said, I will go ahead and turn it over to Grayson, and he will show you the other areas where you can search in the platform.
Very good. Thanks, Evan. Now, great. So what I'm going to be showing you next is what Evan just showed us is, one, a great way of being able to quickly search through all the items within Team Support. Like Evan mentioned a second ago, is that you have the option to look at tickets, customers, contacts, activities, a lot of areas within Team Support that you're able to pull that data. Also, depending on what your workflow is like and what kind of items you are using, you will be able to find search parameters in more than just the basic search and the advanced search over here to the left. You probably have seen these before just by going through different areas if you have access to them or are using them quite a bit. Where I'm going to start off from is going to be in our customer section, but you will be able to find the search bar within our knowledge base, within customers, within products, and also within inventory. So I'll start out with our customer section, and we'll be in to show you exactly what we've been able to do with some new updates that we've made just to our basic search within these sections. So of course, when you come up into any of these areas, you do have a search bar towards the top. And normally it would just be something that we could just search for the customer name if we have it, but depending on what kind of information that we are receiving from the customer, kind of from our scenario, is one of the levels is not working for Donkey Kong as their arcade game that they have purchased. So depending on what we're getting, if we're maybe receiving a phone call, or if we only know the address or their website, whenever you're looking at any records within these sections, a lot of the information that you see pulling up underneath the customer record, you can also pull within the search. So, for instance, if I wanted to look up an address, I can type that in and it will pull only those customers that have addresses. And most of the time, customers also have multiple addresses. So if it's just one or you have three, it will still pull the data depending on what I am adding on here. It will find that information. And just like we saw on the advanced search, it will bold out my query and what it's actually able to pull from my search. Now, something to also keep in mind is I started out with an address. I can also do this with phone numbers. And as you see here, if there's a little plus one on there, that means there's multiple phone numbers associated with this customer. The way that Team Support parses out data is that I cannot type in for instance, in this phone number, I can't type in 856 or 7741 and be able to pull that data. I have to start with my initial numbers to be able to pull that. So if I want to always start out with 214, your area code is going to be your best friend in this case of trying to find the information that you need. It will pull every single one of those customer records whenever I am putting that information in place. Now, I can also, if I'm doing any kind of searching, I can look up my inactive customers. I wanted to make this clear as well, because our inactive customers will actually not show up in our search unless we do have the show inactive box checked. So Adventure Trail Company, if I don't have that, if I try and do a search for the phone number that I have in place here or the customer record, I will not be able to see it. Now, finally, what I'll mention while I'm here on the customer record is for all of you that do use custom fields, I know most of you do, any kind of custom values that you have in place on the customer record will also pull within that search. So if I'm looking up whether this customer is an elite customer, that's just a true or false field, or their preferred delivery method if I wanted to search for that. Going back into these areas, I can search for UPS, it will also find it, and it'll show me over here, custom values is in bold, and same thing just with a regular true or false field. If I wanted just to look at and see really quickly who my elite customers were, just really quickly, I can just pull that, and it will give me that list within my search. Now, I will transition over here real quick. I won't spend too much time on it because it is pretty similar across the board. Same thing can be found when it comes to contacts, is everything again that you see down here towards the bottom can be searched for, including what the customer record is, their email, and there's that multiple item right there if there's more than one, phone numbers as well as addresses can be pulled. And even though they are not displaying here, if I did have any custom field values that are a part of that record, I will also be able to do a search for that on the contact side. Same thing would also apply to products, if that's going to be a big piece with workflow. If I am going to the product first, whenever I'm talking to a customer, to be able to look at some of that information, let's say I look at one of these options here. Let's go into one of our areas, and I'll be able to come and look at what kind of custom field values are here. If I need to pull that data, when I'm looking at products, it will pull the name, it will pull the product line, if any, it'll pull a description if there is any data in place, and again, any kind of custom field values that you have. And finally, what I want to mention as well is inventory. For anyone that does have any kind of tangible item, in this case, for our use case, we do have them, is that if you are going to look at the exact item that is on site for that customer, the search is also here that will look at, again, what product it's associated with. So if I am dealing with Donkey Kong hardware, and this is the actual cabinet, I can look that up on a product level. I can see whether it's assigned or it's in our warehouse. I can look at the actual serial number. That's usually a big way that we're pulling up information from that item. That's usually the first thing we get from a customer, is going to be the serial number. Or again, if I open up any of these items, if there is any custom field values here as well, I will be able to actually pull from that information too. So from that point there, it's going to be very easy whether you are using the advanced search to pull your data, or again, if you just need to do something really quick in any of these items, it makes it really easy to be able to do a quick search, find the information you need, whether it's in the basic search, the advanced search, or any of these other items that you do see that search bar appear towards the top. Now, at this point, we are going to get away from the basics of searching, and we're going to get into some advanced functionality here as far as syntax goes. So I'm going to pass this over to Evan, and he's going to walk us through how we can really get detailed into our search queries.
All right. Thanks, Grayson. So let's go ahead and switch back over to our advanced search page here. So our search tool, the query results do support the following syntax operations that we're going to go out and demonstrate. And we are going to start with the AND operation. So let me go ahead and remove this, and we are going to search for the words third and level. So the AND operation is triggered by the plus sign here. So what this signifies is that a return result must contain both terms third and level. However, they do not have to be in the same field. So you can actually see on ticket 1308, third is in the ticket name, but level is in the ticket actions. If you want to have an exact match, there is an exact match operation that we'll get to a little bit later. So let's switch from the and actually go into an or situation. So that is going to be with the key here. Let me take out the plus sign here, and I'm going to put in the vertical bar. So that is going to be our or operation. So that will give us results that have either one of the terms listed there, third or level. Now, a return result may include both of the key terms, but again, we were just looking for third or level. Or if we change our search here and go with Donkey Kong, we can actually see there was this 1179 here that was misspelled. So they forgot the E there, so it wouldn't have returned in our Donkey Kong search. So that OR operation helps us find Donkey or Kong, so we can pretty easily see this was meant to be part of the Donkey Kong search as well. Now let's talk about how we can negate a term here. So I'm going to switch my search back to Donkey Kong. Now, as we've talked previously, our issue is concerning the Now we do have the result where it has the fourth level here. Wanted to remove that term specifically. We want to make sure that fourth is not included in our search. we can use a minus symbol, and then don't put a space between the term that you're wanting to negate, and let's type in fourth. So we are now searching for the terms Donkey Kong, but we are restricting the specific term fourth. Again, do not put a space in between your minus section, like you saw the spaces between and around our plus sign in our vertical. All right, now we can do the exact search here. So to do the exact search, we're going to go back to our third level search, but we are going to wrap it with some quotation marks here. So we are going to type in third level. So our return results this time have to have the phrase specifically third level in our parentheses there. So that's going to be your difference between the and operation and the or operation. So parentheses there, or quotation marks rather, for your exact matches. All right, so now let's talk about our prefix query. So this is going to be for things that involve a partial search. So we're going to abandon the Donkey Kong example for a second. And now we're going to look for related tickets that are concerning our Galaga machines. Now, Galaga is a not only a mouth word fumble, but it could be something that someone doesn't know how to spell. So what we want to do is we want to add a star to the end of our search gal, and that is going to pull up all the tickets that have those three characters, but then it's adding on any other terms such as Galaga, Aliga with an I instead of an A, and then also you can see it's also returning the result for Gallon. So again, this is used for partial searches. And where that is going to come into play is for areas that do not support a partial search, like ticket actions. So just keep that in mind when you're doing your partial search by adding on the star at the end. All right, so the last operation that we have is to signify precedence when there are multi-term phrases. So I know that's a little bit of a mouthful here, so let's start by typing it all out. So we're going to start with the term level, but we want to search for the terms third level or jungle level. We want to search for two phrases at once. To do that, we're going to add some parentheses. We're going to type in the word jungle. Then we're going to use our operation. So we're going to combine a couple of the searches here. And then we're going to type in the word third, and then wrap that all with the parentheses. You can see the spaces in between each indicator in the operation. So again, what we are searching for here is both terms, third level or jungle level. So the return results have to include the word level, and then or jungle or third in the returned results. So again, I know that's a little tricky and maybe a little bit tricky to work with there. So if you do have any follow-up questions on that, feel free to raise any questions in our Q&A or with our support team afterwards. So those are the examples that we support in the syntax operations. You have the and operation, again, with the plus sign. You've got your vertical bar. You can add the minus sign to negate. Our quotation marks for exact match. A star for partial search. And then finally, to signify precedence, wrapping it around with parentheses there. All right, so I am going to actually turn it back over to Grayson here. He is going to show you another way to filter down your data and options. So the floor is yours, Grayson.
Thanks, Evan. There's one other thing I did want to point out while I was just like listening to you go through the syntax is a lot of people already know this, especially those that do use our knowledge base quite a bit. I'm also having some spelling problems here. As we are pulling in any kind of data and looking for something, and there we go. I did that actually the other day. Donkey King is not Donkey Kong. There we go. Is that whenever you are pulling any kind of data, and from our scenario here for Donkey Kong, third jungle level not working, fourth level glitch, what you'll normally see, we have actually made a pretty new update to the icons that appear here when you are doing any kind of searches, is that you will see, since our knowledge base articles are built off of tickets, is that if you are looking for something very specific, that is like for this case, a third area problem, I'm seeing a couple of these different tickets that have come in pretty recently for these two. If you ever see an icon, in this place we have a ticket, and then we also have these three books that are leaning up against each other, we then know that we do have a knowledge base article that might be a good candidate for being able to answer these questions. So kind of trying to make any kind of knowledge base article that you have a very case specific in the title is going to make it really simple when you are doing these searches and looking for information to see if there is a knowledge base article already in place that might be able to solve any of these tickets that aren't currently closed. So I just want to make that quick update there. Now, another way, and this doesn't go specifically into our search, but we are in the business of trying to make your data, again, really easy to access and really easy to be able to filter down your data. So beyond just the search, the basic search, we also have the ability to create different filters and views within Team Support. This was probably something that we did mention when we were doing our reporting webinar a few months ago. But one of the functionalities that we have that we can keep everything on the far left side of our menu bar is something called ticket views. Now, every one of these items that you do see here, if they already appear here with an icon, are going to be our ticket types. But what I've created just a little bit ago were these three items down here that look at our three different games of Donkey Kong, Galaga, and one we haven't talked about today is Mortal Kombat. And what ability you actually have to do whenever you're looking at reporting is, if I don't want to look at every single one of my tickets, I still want to be able to get a different view and list and a little bit more information right in front of me that has different data points for me to look at, I can create a ticket view for that. That gives me everything right in front of my face. So a lot of this, if I do click from one to the other, this is only giving me the list of open tickets or closed tickets right now for the products of Donkey Kong, Galaga, and Mortal Kombat. So easily I can definitely come in and say the bulk of our tickets have come in from Mortal Kombat for that product. I can see kind of the next down is going to be our Donkey Kong, and that'll give me that list of tickets as well with all of these different bits of information. Now, to create that is actually pretty simple to do. If you scroll down to the very bottom into our report sections and you go in and click on create, one of those options is going to be ticket view. So I'll give that a click. And something just to keep in mind whenever you are creating something like this, and it's pretty simple to at least get started. Let's see, I'm gonna go ahead and call this PM for Pac-Man and call this hardware. And depending on what you select here in the private report option, if you say everyone can see it, it's going to show up in the all tickets dropdown. If you say only I can see it, that means we're going to keep it to ourselves. Not everyone can see it. It'll show up in our My Ticket section instead. So I want everyone to be able to have access to this, being that it's the Christmas season. Sharing is caring. So I'm going to hit next. And then just like any type of standard report that you are using, you can pick the field specific to that ticket. So I'm going to pick just a few of these really quickly. Just kind of go through ticket type, ticket number, status, maybe the severity of the ticket. I do want the product to show up there since we are talking about Pac-Man, so I do want that there. Maybe the assigned to, the contacts, the customer, and just for fun, maybe the days opened I'll put there. And then of course, if you do have any custom fields based off of your ticket types, you can also add those in place as well. I'm gonna go ahead and click next. And since I do want to filter by product in the same way, you can filter on any bit of data. So it's not just giving you everything or just the standard fields that you normally see in the all tickets or the my tickets. You can filter your data to make this even more specific to what you need on a day-to-day basis to look at that data. So I am actually going to look for just product. And that's all I need. I can just keep it as an is, or I can make that a contains if I want to, or is not, or is empty. You'll see a number of those options here in the second dropdown, depending on what type of filter you're adding here. I'm going to say contains. So I'm not sure exactly how I did the spelling. So I'm going just to put in pack and click save. And that will give me my tickets specifically for that product. As you can see, we have a lot of hardware, one software for our Pac-Man product. And as you see down here, it will create a new ticket view that I can go and just click from one to the other to be able to get a comprehensive list of all of the tickets that I'm currently working on or anyone else within my organization is working on for those individual products. So, to kind of finish this off here is that what we're able to do within this, if we want to get very specific in what we're looking for, the advanced search allows you to be able to do a lot of standard filtering, being able to look for very detailed items using the syntax commands that Evan talked about just a little bit earlier. You can also be able to get comprehensive lists to look for the information we're looking for, either through one of the sections down here in customers, products, and inventory, or any kind of ticket view that you'd like to create just for a quick click to move over from item to find the tickets that you're looking for. Now, Evan, before we pass this off and we kind of look at the questions that have started to come in, is there anything that I might have missed or anything you'd like to add real quick?
Not that I can think of. Great job going over the ticket views there, but I think we have covered everything that we needed for today.
Perfect. Now I'll go and check to see, Evan, were there any questions that came in that maybe to answer or share with everyone that's on the webinar?
Yes. So we actually did have one question come in, and it was, are all of these search options and tips available in your knowledge base or support site? So the answer is yes. I did answer that in the questions panel there, but they can be found within our knowledge base. And also the knowledge base article specific to the advanced search technology is linked to our community post for this particular TSU. So when you are looking out for the trivia question here in just a couple minutes, you'll also be able to find the advanced search KB article as well.
Perfect.
But that is the only question that we've got.
Very good. Okay. Well, guys, the last thing we'll mention again is that we will be posting our trivia question, as Evan mentioned. And since I do have the screen up, I'll just go ahead and show you exactly where we're going to go. Is if you go after this webinar ends over to our help link in the top right hand corner in Team Support and click on our support hub. It should log you in automatically. You can just click on our community tab and you are going to go into Team Support University. It should be fourth from the top, right here under Team Support Forums. You can give that a click and you should be able to see right up here towards the top, different ways to search within Team Support. You can go in and click on that in just a few minutes. We will post this at 11:40 Central Standard Time. So go on over there and just take a look for that trivia question. When you go and click on it, you should be able to see a couple things here. We've already put a couple of links to our knowledge base, like that viewer asked a little bit ago, but look for our trivia question here. All you have to do is click add reply, put your answer in, and again, the first person that goes and answers that question will receive our prize for today.
All right, great. Well, I think that is gonna wrap it up for us, so we will just go ahead and leave you guys here. Let's pull up our thank you page here. So again, just wanted to thank you guys for taking your time out of your day here for joining us on our TSU webinar for this morning. We do want to wish you guys a safe and happy holiday season here. We do have a question, one more question that just came in. How will we get the video? The video will be linked in our TSU page through that you can get through our support hub as well. It will also be on that same community topic that we had just reviewed over there. So we will make sure that that gets uploaded here within the next day or so. But again, just wanted to thank everyone for joining us here this morning. Grayson, any last thoughts or anything?
Just last thought, for everyone that did register, you should also receive an email with the video. So it'll just be a couple of days for us to get that up and running. But like Evan said, it will be posted, but you should get an email from us with a copy of that video. Once we get all that set up, then you should get that in your inbox soon.
All right, great. Well, happy holidays, everyone. We'll go ahead and wrap up our TSU for today. Be on the lookout for that give you a question here in the next minute or two. But you guys have a good rest of your day, a happy holidays, and thank you again for joining us.
Thanks, everyone. Have a great day.